welcome back to the LDM Show. And if you just tuned in, we did the first time Facebook Live.
Don't get happy. You missed it.
We don't do it all the time. We need the ratings. So, but we did it one time because it was a battle. Well, not really a battle.
Yeah,
when it comes
to
men and women, it's always the men win anyway.
Yeah, right.
It's
always the women. You're lying. You see how we go again? It's the women.
Listen,
the women
watch
won.
The video. You
women
see.
Won. Women win. Women Listen. Always win.
Yeah, come out with all the excuses.
Here we go. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, think about sex in the first 5 seconds of meeting a guy.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, y'all have your girlfriend on speed dial to call you back.
But y'all wear the panties.
Listen, we'll talk about that. We'll probably wear the panties for a trophy, maybe. I don't know about all that now. But anyway, without further ado, you know, we've been announcing that he's going to be on our show. He's part of the Nightline family here. So he does so much, from the closing line to bringing out the hip-hop artists to doing ciphers.
Nice.
You know,
I like
going to Atlanta and doing some stuff too, you know.
He's known. Okay, yeah.
OCH Radio own CEO, the founder, Molly PX, is in the house.
Yeah.
What's going on, Ma?
LDM Show, what's poppin', man?
Hey, you know. So like I said, you know, Molly, he's showing his, you know, OCH logo right there, his brand right now.
I'm just trying to say, I don't like to use the word trying. I'm just basically, you know, touching all audiences and letting them know that, you know, we out here, we're a brand that you could definitely trust, you know.
For the people that don't know, tell us, like, how did you come out bringing OCH Radio out?
Well, OCH Radio pretty much came from the brand OCH is an acronym for Official Clock Huggers. Official Clock Huggers was birthed in 2008. It's really for the working people going across the globe. Everybody that collectively moves the world forward. You know, all class working folk. And, you know, with the radio, we needed a constant media outlet. And, you know, I was basically touring around the city, the tri-state, going to different radio shows and, you know, trying to really put OCH on the map. And, you know, I came to Nightline, and Nightline, you know, gave me an opportunity and believed in me. And here I am, man, you know,
yeah,
to this day.
Right.
That's good. Especially, you know, you got your closing line out with the OCH, so people rocking it out here and there, stuff like that. So,
well, that's pretty dope, because, you know, actually the clothing line represents everybody collectively. You know, it really stands for what you go out there and do, whatever your profession is. So, you know, it's not like you're wearing it to represent me. You're not, you know, and it's not like you're doing it to put any currency in my pocket. You know, it's pretty much, I do a lot of charity events where, you know, I don't make a dime. You know, the fact is that, you know, the networking and the growth and the your audiences and our audiences collectively coming together, you know, that means more to me than just, you know, profit.
Yeah, believe me, I know. It's like all these places we got to go to, people thinking we're making, you know, buckets of money. We really don't.
No.
Half of the time is the network. We got to bring ourselves up first before we can. Can't go there and be like, yo, listen, I got to charge you for having me on your show. Well, who are you? You know what I'm saying? Like, who are you, first of all?
I believe the networking is more money. It's more than the money.
Yeah, overall, it's going to be.
Because you network. You're building your own community.
Mm-hmm.
As you build your own community, that community within itself can bring more currency. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Who you know, what you know, what they do.
Mm-hmm.
What the people that you're meeting, who they know.
Mm-hmm.
And the people they know.
Mm-hmm.
So it keeps going. So it's not all about what you could get in money wise, is what you get either retaining the knowledge and the information or the society you're trying to become within itself, you know.
Yeah.
So I respect that.
And it's like, you know, when you're from both worlds, like, you know, you have, you know, not to put my age out there, but I paid attention growing up, so I knew that the footwork meant me getting out there myself, elbows down. And, you know, and the new age, virally, you know, you have the internet and the media. So, you know, with both of those entities, you know, it just became a global impact.
And right.
I'm grateful for that, you know. And a lot of people really come through OCH to, you know, to find jobs, to get on a platform, to do their performances and different things that they, you know, bring out their talents. And the networking is phenomenal. It's, you know, it's really something that is going to be here for a long time.
It's like a key.
Man.
You have the grounds for like hip hop. Like everyone basically in the hip hop world comes towards your show and stuff. Have you ever had like someone that you was like, this guy ain't going nowhere? Mm-hmm. Or you ever had people like, wow, why is this not guy not more famous than he is now?
Well, you know, I've had moments where I've talked to a few stars as far as the category that they put them in. Like they put them in A, B, and C.
Right.
From A, B to C, I've talked to all different types of people. But the A class stars, you know, a lot of the 90s artists.
Right.
Today, they don't have the resources, and they definitely don't have the willpower to make that transition over to the media, the viral aspect of the game. They're still stuck in how they had to come up in the early 80s and that method that they had to use. Now, the 90s artists that actually switched over to current events as far as the media and things like that, they pretty much are, you know, relevant. But the other ones are not, because, you know, they don't understand that it's a different age. It's a computer age. And if you don't switch over, you know, you're going to be stuck in like a time warp.
Yeah.
And it hinders you.
Yeah.
So it becomes a factor where, okay, we link up and you're like, damn, I went on your show and I got so much response, because leading up to the show, I give you promotion. During the show, we give you promotion. And then after the show, the footage from the show, we give you promotion. So it helps catapult them into where they're forced to deal with how to maneuver today virally. And I'm grateful for that, because they definitely needed it. A lot of them needed it, man.
Yeah. I've seen a couple of shows where some of the hip-hop artists, I'd be like, ooh, okay.
Yeah.
Ooh, you're lucky you're on this show, because you needed it.
Yeah.
You needed it as much as possible. But then some of them do get laid back, because they think, because they got on the show, they made it somewhere, you know. And then they lean back a little bit, you know.
And see, the thing with me, you know, I just don't limit you to what we're doing. Like, you know, when you get to meet me, and you get to network with me, like, the doors open up in so many different avenues. Like, you know, and I'm like, yo, who else got shows on Nightline? I tell them, you know, the LDM show, you know, Jose Rivera, the Extremity show. I think we have another show called Flavor to Flavor. We just start networking together.
She
came from somewhere else, but the fact is, you know, I just don't limit OCH Radio. It's just about us. You know, because at the end of the day, when you open up the doors for other things and other people to walk in, and people like yourself that, you know, you can actually trust me referring somebody to you and vice versa, you know, our names is all we have. So we don't want to tarnish that.
Believe me, there's many people that be like, oh, can I be on your show? Or if they were on my show, hey, you know anybody else? I'd be like, I can find out, but, you know, I'd be lying. I'd be like, they really don't want to network. It's because, like you said, that's my name. If I tell you, hey, Molly, I got this guy, and then he's on your show, you'd be like, yo, Charles, this guy is no good. Why? Now he goes my name, now you won't trust me anymore.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a lot of people, and if you guys are watching, this is the reasons why sometimes we cannot bring you to another show.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there had to be something that you did that wasn't, you know.
We've had past shows that people referred people here, and like we had to abruptly stop the show and go to commercial or whatever, because, you know, they claimed that, you know, they can come and they can rhyme or whatever they was doing, and then when we put them on the spot, it's like, you know, you come up here and you choke, because you see the lights and the cameras all around you, and then it's usually people in the background shooting, and then you got the live DJ, and it's a different, it's a whole different situation.
Yeah.
So, you know, and people just got to understand, man, you know, at the end of the day, this is your brand. This is your legacy that you're going to leave behind. So if you're going to do it, man, you need to really be focused. Be into your craft. Because I'm sure that you can open up a liquor bottle and roll a blunt. So put that time into your craft.
That's a fact.
I agree
with that, because it a lot of people do come to radio shows or even in a safe and they claim that, yeah, I got bars, I got this and that, but so go ahead, spit a cappella, mm-hmm. do something, show me your work, and mm-hmm. they have nothing.
Because mm-hmm. a real MC is supposed to ride any beat.
Anything.
There was times I had the honor to be sitting on the side while he had his cypher on Molly BX's show, so... And there's some of them that I'd be like, bet you if I throw a word out there, he'll be all screwed, you know? Mm-hmm. Because you can tell the way when they rap, mm-hmm. you're doing it from the dome. No, you're doing it from the memory.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You're rapping mm-hmm. on something that you already said before.
Mm-hmm. And only I see certain that a lot. MCs caught on when you throw a word out there. Certain MCs catch it and flip it, mm-hmm. and then certain ones are stuck.
Yeah.
There was one, and my hat's off to him, but I forgot his name. He was sitting down, the first one ever I seen that was doing it from the top, because he said everything about things that were here. Yeah. He was like, yo, I'm in the Molly BX. He was like, engineers over there. He was like, and then he looked around, he would say something about the light. Whatever it is, he would say something about it. And I was like, that is off the dome.
Mm-hmm. I'm that kind of rapper only when I'm drunk. You see? Hello.
Like I said,
I got bars when
the only time I'm a good rapper is on Christmas when I rap the
bars when I'm drinking. Yeah. It's not good bars.
Yeah. But guys, if you just logged in, we're over here talking with Molly BX from the OCH radio. He's live every Sunday from 6 to 8. You gotta check him out on nightlineradio.com. So he's around. So we're just talking, shooting the breeze. So if you just logged on right now and watching, that's who we're talking to right now. But you know, Molly, you did, like I said, you opened the doors to a lot of the hip hop artists and things like that. And then you're doing other stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Like you're trying to take your shows out to other places.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me a little bit about like what you, and plus you're the only show basically I see that has hosts from other genres.
I wanted to touch on that also. First I wanted to let you know that, you know, pretty much the networking through Official Clock Huggers, you know, like I said, is globally. We have a lot of different entities from other states, and they reach out and they want to network. And you know, I'm not opposed to, you know, branching out and networking, but I just got to be selective on who I do it with, because mm-hmm. a lot of the people, you know, they'll use you to build their ratings up, and then when they get them where they feel that they, you know, they don't need you, it's just like, you know, whatever. Mm-hmm. But you know, those type of people I really put in a category of opportunists. I still don't close the door on opportunists,
right?
But you know, I kind of keep them at arm's length. But a lot of the people that really do catapult our show into the next realm is because, you know, they want it as much as we do.
Right.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And our cast, I went a route with the show in the beginning where I did a female host and myself, and it just didn't work out. It didn't work out because the element of Official Clock Huggers is different working people, different people that has brands. It's not a panel of you wait for Molly BX to say and then you speak. No, it's a panel of everybody has their own brand. Everybody has their own businesses. Mm-hmm. You're basically coming together like a syndicate, like a you know, you come to our board and you have a panel of strong-willed people, and you come up here, you're gonna get the different opinions, the different feedbacks from everybody collectively, mm-hmm. rather than just one person and it's scripted. Oh, Molly BX talk, he say something funny, and it's a dry joke. Just hit the buttons, because you know, we didn't want to come at it in that way,
right?
You know, so. When we do the Facebook Live and Instagram Live for the behind the scenes, that's actually what's going on. Like, mm-hmm. we're really spontaneous with it. And a lot of the questions and stuff is not where we have a curriculum or a script.
Mm-hmm.
Every interview is based on you, who the person is. Yeah. So it's not like it's a structured interview
script. Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? And it's dope because, you know, if all of us is here on the panel, we have, you know, a crazy show because of all the different personalities. But either way, you're still going to get different people. And the guest DJs we have, we handpick certain DJs across the city. And they come and they feature and they play their sets and then they give their opinions and their feedbacks and, you know, on the show. You know, so it's pretty smart. Dope, man.
Yeah, yeah. Being a guest and watching four people in front of you, it's like you're in the Judge Judy type of thing, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. No, but it's fun.
Was sign. Be like, yeah, all these.
It's fun though because now you have a selective opinions and thoughts and questions because not everybody's gonna ask the same question. Everybody wants to know something different.
Mm-hmm.
So having different people in a panel and not being scripted. You see, we're not scripted. We're live. We just like going ready. Woo, 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 straight up. Whatever comes out. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
It's great to have that because you don't want to sit there behind being the guest that's sitting there and you're like just waiting. Okay, he's just talking, blah, blah, blah. Okay, and everybody's just watching. No. Now it's your mic, your mic, your mic, and then mine.
Well, it's really dope for us because, you know, I really admire the fact that we're touching all audiences. We had, for the last four shows, because we had canceled... We had to reschedule two shows because of emergencies with Nightline. So the last four shows that we had Fort Dix Federal Corrections Facility tuned in. Their day room had us going live over the speakers of the recreation room in the prison. And we had all types of inmates like really listening in and then on the phone with their family members, having them log on and tune in. And then it got to the point where, okay, they're sending talent now. And I don't know how the feds offer this, but they can get on Facebook and they can get on Twitter and they can get on the internet.
Yeah.
So they're actually logged on.
They have phones now.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
They have phones now.
Yeah, so they're actually logged on, FaceTiming, and you see them all in the background. Oh, OCH Radio, OCH Radio. Yo, man, that really moved me.
That's real.
Yeah, it's a great thing when you can see that what you wanted. Like you said, I'm just going to do the show, and it's going to go across the street. No. And you realize it's in Fordham Road. You know, like, so many sections out there. Because
of that networking.
Yeah. And the part of the networking is if you're good, the next person will tell the next person and so on and so forth. When we did the independent awards yesterday, matter of fact, we said, you know what, let me see who's listening to our podcast and all that. We have 95 hours a day of listening. So I was like, wait a minute, last month it was like only 50 hours. And to me, I was like 95 hours, but then I realized, wait a minute, we only got 24 hours a day.
Mm-hmm.
So 95 hours, that means there's at least 5 to 6 people every hour listening.
Consistently,
Consistently listening to the podcast
and then
bringing it back. So I was like, wow, we must be doing something right.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not the what we do, is how we do it.
And you know, and not for nothing, you know, I get a lot of offers from other stations, but I'm really... loyal. I've always been a loyal person, and my thing is, Nightline gave me my first shot because at the end of the day, like I said, I was running around the city going on tour, and it became a factor where it was growing pains, and it was really frustrating. But we weathered the storm, and then you know the dope engineer that we have on Sunday, you know, he actually, you know, he's patient with us and. Yeah. And he actually, you know, helps out a lot.
You know, now that he brings that up,
the structure part of it. You know,
it's so
what I mean?
Funny because I tell some people, yeah, you seen Bobby BX's show? He's like, yeah. How you like the changing of the cameras? How do you like the sound, the colors? And they'd be like, oh, it's pretty good. Okay, if it's not good, we'd be like, it's not good.
Mm-hmm.
And then when I told a friend of mine, yeah, I changed his format a little, and I told them when to go on commercials, when to come back.
Yeah.
And they was like, but why? He's another show.
It helps.
Nah,
it doesn't matter.
Let me tell
and
you.
Plus, I'm helping him, and I'm learning more of what to react to and what not to react to. Because there was times where his guest was no good. I was like, and he'd be like, okay, we got to. And I put his theme song.
Yeah.
I'd be, oh, he hears his theme song. He know he got to go to commercial break.
And see, and that was the issue also with past hosts that I tried to, you know, build with, because they wasn't willing to trust the engineer.
Right.
You know, the engineer has his own show, has his own network, is doing his own thing. I'm grateful for that because, see, now that tells me that where I go wrong, even his family's home watching.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, my family's watching. So it's like, okay, he has to take that hat off because we're watching at home. And
yeah, my wife, remember my wife texts? I was like, yo, well, we got to come commercial break. My wife said,
oh, that's me all the time. Every time I wear a blue shirt, Frank is like, sorry, Emma, you got to change. Yeah. You're blending in with the walls. Yeah. We only see your hair.
I don't want to cut you guys off, but we've been talking to Molly BX. We're going to come back right now from a commercial break because we got to, you know, pay some bills. But we'll be right back with more with Molly BX, and we'll be talking more.